Hello, my name is Kurt Gibson, and I'm on the administrative staff at the Illinois High School Association. One of my responsibilities is to work with our boys basketball program, and I'd like to welcome you to this presentation. I call it the pre-state finals planning presentation for the IHSA boys basketball state finals. Just had over the years just become apparent to me over time that, you know, that window from winning the super sectional game on now Monday night until such time when you play in the state finals, there's a really narrow window and there's a lot that goes on. So I put this together really with you in mind, hoping that this gives you a chance to start thinking about a few key topics during sectional week as it leads into super sectional Monday, so that should your team be fortunate enough to win the super sectional, you're ready to, you know, handle the planning process, if you will, that goes into getting ready for the state finals. And I hope the year's been a good one. We're excited to be going back to a live in-person state finals tournament. And we're excited that the tournament is returning to the University of Illinois. It's been a long time, about a quarter of a century since the tournament was held in Champain, where it held had a very long history. And we know that to get to the state finals is no easy task, and winning a regional is no easy task. And for your school to be advancing into the sectional play is a reflection of a lot of things, including the leadership that you and others on your administrative team provide at your school. So congratulations on the season to date. As I mentioned, this presentation is designed to help you with planning. And I'm going to go ahead here and share my screen, because I want to make sure that I also, early on here in the presentation, share with you my email address, and you see it there. And I would just say that at any point in time, from now until through the state tournament, if you have questions about anything, please feel free to reach out to me. I'm good about checking email and following up with people, so use that as needed. So in the presentation, I want to talk about four main topics: lodging, tickets, credentials, and then awards. Let's talk first about lodging. We're very fortunate that the Visit Champaign County Convention and Visitors Bureau has worked with the hotel properties in the Champaign-Urbana community to identify hotels to serve as team hotels for the schools reaching the state finals. And I'm going to sort of jump to the bottom of this slide here. You can see that we've got a contact with Visit Champaign County, Mike Kuhn. Mike has done a tremendous job in working with properties and identifying properties that are interested in hosting your teams. And he's made arrangements to reserve, if you will, 15 rooms for your school during the tournament. There's information in the box of materials you receive after winning the super sectional game, and specifically there's information inside of there for lodging. There will be a document inside of there that tells you what hotel is sort of attached to your super sectional. It'll have a contact person there, and it'll also list the name of a team host who will work with your team while you're in Champaign-Urbana to, you know, navigate everything from best route to get from hotel to the arena to where can we have a practice, where can we find a meal. These are folks that are connected with the Champaign-Urbana community, and they'll be very helpful during your stay. I just want to emphasize, while the IHSA office will be sending your school a stipend following the tournament for reaching the state finals, your school will be responsible for the payment that's associated with the cost of the rooms and any other kind of ancillary things, any ancillary kinds of charges for your stay during the state finals. Should your school make the state finals, I'll be hosting a pre-state final virtual meeting for those school administrators and coaches, and I'll talk a little bit more at that time about the stipend. But the real takeaway is lodging will have been arranged. Rooms are reserved, your school will pay for the rooms, and eventually you'll get a reimbursement from the IHSA that's designed to cover some of the costs that you're going to incur at the state finals. It's unlikely that the stipend's going to cover everything, but it is designed to help reduce some of the expenses that you'll incur. Second topic I want to touch on are tickets. And the easiest way to describe this is that in order to have a seat to watch the games, everyone will need a ticket. There's no pass list at the state finals. We're going to talk in a second about credentials, and while our office provides some credentials to schools, those are really designed more to allow people access to places regular fans can't go. To watch the games, you need a ticket. A ticket carries with it the ability to sit in an assigned seat. None of the seats will be general admission at the State Farm Center. The biggest part of the information in your super sectional box pertains to tickets. And in keeping with the association's move to digital ticketing, the majority of tickets that you'll be able to make available to your fans will be digital tickets. There will be a limited number of hard tickets that you'll have to sell. We'll talk about those in just a second. All the ticket prices have been established by the IHSA Board of Directors, and the tickets closest to the floor, so the lower bowl seats, are going to have a little bit higher price point than the ones that are a little bit higher in the 200 level, and we'll see that in just a second. Want to point out that metal detectors will be in place at the State Farm Center. This is all per the State Farm Center policy, and they do have a clear bag policy, and there's information on that in your super sectional box and on our website. We just ask that you share that with your fans as well, so they're not caught off guard when they come to the arena for the state finals. Now, I mentioned the tickets that you'll have to sell, and the majority are going to be, like I said, digital tickets, although there are some hard tickets that you're going to have at your disposal to sell. So let's look at those here on this next slide, where we see a diagram, if you will, of the State Farm Center arena. On the left, we can see the color coding. We've got student seats, 100 level seats, and 200 level seats. Over on the right hand side of the diagram, then we begin to see where those areas are. So let's talk for just a minute about those. First, you're going to have 78 hard tickets. You actually have 156. You have 78 for the first game your school plays and 78 tickets for the second game your school plays in two different envelopes. Those are tickets that you can sell to students, and they're really only for students. And those are in those orange crush seats that the University of Illinois student fans sit in when their men's basketball team is playing at home. And we've sort of outlined in red sections 9, 10, 12, and 13 to give you a sense of those are right on the floor and right behind the bench seats. Those are premium seats that are for students only. Your school is not going to have all of Section 9 and Section 10. You're going to have 78 seats in likely a couple of those sections. They'll be together, so all your students will be together and, you know, cheer for their team and whatnot. But those are really premium seats. We would suggest you're going to need to have supervision down there, so I'm suggesting you maybe pull two tickets or however many you think you need to pull and sell. You're going to sell these, but these are going to be for your adult supervisors who will be down there with your students. You're also going to have, then, if we look at the blue level in the 100s, and I've just circled 109 here as one example, but you're going to have a limited number. It's 46 tickets that you're going to be able to sell to fans, whether it's parents or teachers or school board members. You'll be able to choose that. You'll be able to sell in one of these lower bowl sections, either 109, 110, 112, or 13. It'll sort of match up where your student fans are. And you're going to be able to do that because inside of the ticketing envelope, not only we have the hard tickets, the two envelopes, 78 hard tickets in each of two envelopes, but you're also going to have a document from the box office, and there will be two codes that you're going to be able to distribute to fans. One code will allow fans to buy tickets in this lower bowl, if you will, 100 level section seats. And then the bulk of your fans, you're going to share a different code that will enable them to buy tickets in the 200 section where all of your fans will be gathered as well. So it'll just be a matter of you really sharing the code that the State Farm Center box office has created with your fans, and you can choose which fans get which code, and that'll determine what kind of seats they can purchase. I do want to point out, as we sort of think about then entry into the arena, and you've had the information in your super sectional box about this, but this is going to be a little bit of a new twist as well for our office this year as we make the move into a new venue. But you're going to need to bring your teams in, your teams and your cheerleaders, and they're probably going to be in separate buses or vehicles through the team security entrance, which is located at the bottom of the East Tunnel. So your buses are going to have to come in off of 4th Street, and you can see where the entryway is. It's in that sort of orangish circle. That is a, I'm going to call it a one-way tunnel. So your bus, if it drives in forward to the tunnel and drops the team or cheerleaders off, it's then going to have to back out straight back. So they may choose to somehow turn into the northeast lot there and then back it in so they can go out forward. It's really up to them, but I want to just emphasize it's not the kind of tunnel or drop off where they'll drop in, let the players or cheerleaders out, and then drive out the other end of the arena. And this is an area where only the team members who are on your team list, and we'll see that here shortly, and cheerleaders can enter. That's going to be a fairly secure area, and so we don't want anybody other than cheerleaders or people on your team list to come in through that entrance for the duration of the tournament. I mentioned the clear bag policy a minute ago. It's right here. You can see it on this slide as well. Information is available on the clear bag policy on the boys basketball page as well. And I maybe shouldn't have buried the lead for some of you, but this will be a mask optional event. Masks are not required for anyone, fans, players, coaches, officials. Certainly if somebody wants to wear a mask, that's certainly their personal choice to do so. We would ask everyone to be respectful of anyone making a choice to wear a mask or not wear a mask. But as the mitigations have softened around our state, we want everybody to know that the event will be, mask optional for all participants. All right, let's talk just briefly about credentials then, because as I mentioned, credentials really just allow people to move about into other areas of the arena. So we can see here on the right, these are the four credentials that the competing teams will receive. You can see they're different. They differ different colors for different classes kind of thing. But you can see that each school, and this is all per the terms and conditions, will receive the following: up to 22 competing team passes. Those are for your coaches who meet IHSA coaching requirements, your team roster. If you have others who are, a videographer, a high school student, and these others have to be high school students, videographers or managers, that sort of creates your list of 22, and that you can have up to 22. If you don't have 22, that's fine as well. You'll also be able to receive 3 administrative passes, and the administrative passes will be available at the will call window at the box office. You'll need to bring some form of identification to be able to pick those up. And those passes are designed for the superintendent, principal, and athletic director. There are 14 cheerleading passes, 12 for cheerleaders, 1 for a mascot, and 1 for your coach. And those were included in the super sectional box. Additional cheerleading information was in there as well, but each super sectional box had inside of the cheerleading envelope, if you will, those 14 passes for cheerleaders. So they will have those and be ready to have those displayed when they enter the State Farm Center through that team security entrance on Thursday or Friday. And then you have the possibility, if you have a certified athletic trainer, to put that on your team list. That would not count as one of your 22. It'd sort of be an additional pass. And we work with your school once we know you've got one to get them connected with the medical staff for the tournament. We mentioned already that For safety purposes, the teams and cheerleaders through the duration of the tournament, even if they're just coming to watch in a session that they're not playing in, can come in through that team security entrance. They'll need to have their passes with them at all times. We would suggest that when your team is coming over to play, that maybe the players give their passes to somebody to hold on to or keep them in the locker room so they don't get, you know, left at the bottom of a gym bag or something. We've had those kinds of things get lost in the past, and these are fairly important items, so we don't want that to happen if it's at all possible. So the credentials do not take the place of a ticket. If you want a seat in the arena to watch the games, you'll need to buy a ticket. The credentials really just get you into places, and for the administrative passes, for example, that'll get you sort of under the arena. It'll get you on the floor for awards. Whereas regular, you know, fans are not going to be allowed on the floor. Parents won't be allowed on the floor. It'll just be, particularly when we get to awards, it'll just be those with the competing team passes and or the administrative ones. So let's talk about that team list. I mentioned it briefly. We're going to be, this was also what you see here. A copy of this was in your super sectional box as well. We'll be sending this to your school as well after you win your super sectional game. But this is where you let us know who your coaches and players are. If you have a manager, like I said, if they're a high school age student and they're a manager or videographer and they've been with your team all year, you know, you can list them here on the list. And these are the folks then who will be coming in that team security entrance at the bottom of the East Tunnel. I'm asking that you send those this completed form back to me by noon on Wednesday, March 9th. That way we can begin making our preparations and getting that information to the folks who will be manning the security entrance and make sure we have all the credentials in line so that when your team arrives, we can make that a pretty seamless kind of process, get them in, get them into their locker room so they can get ready for their game. But be on the leave. When you win the super sectional, look for this document as well, and you can begin, you know, working on that as soon as Tuesday morning and getting that to us. We'll then take that form really and turn it into an awards form as well. You can see an example of that here on the left. We'll add in the administrative names. We have those in our database, so we'll be able to pull those easily and add them to this. I'll be in touch with the competing school administrators during the weekend, getting sort of the final okay on that, making sure people know when to report to the floor, where to be, and those kinds of things. There's information on how the awards will unfold in the super sectional box as well. I would just point out that on Thursday and Friday, the third and fourth place awards for each class will be given out following that consolation game. So when on Thursday night, for example, the 1A consolation game is played, once it's completed, those awards will be distributed. We'll then play the 2A consolation game, and when that game's over, those awards will be distributed. Do the same thing on Friday for classes 3A and 4A, and then on Saturday, again, after each championship game, we'll have an awards ceremony where the trophies and medallions are presented to each of the schools playing in those respective games. We'll then take a formal photo on the floor of the team, and then the teams will then leave the floor as we get ready for the next game or we just have ended the session at that point. And we'll talk much more about this during that virtual administrators meeting the week of the state finals. But just wanted you to really know, we'll take the team list, add the administrators in, and really sort of put that together for you. So that should be what I hope is a pretty seamless process as well. So thanks again for taking time out to view this presentation. I hope it at least gets you thinking about some of those key elements that are associated with coming to the state finals. We wish everybody continued great luck on the tournament trail, and we look forward to working with those of you who do in fact qualify for the state finals this year at the State Farm Center on the campus of the University of Illinois at Champaign-Urbana. Thanks again. Take care.